क्लास 8 स्टूडेंट्स वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 1 ऑफ ज्योग्राफी एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड वीडियो एंड वी आर डूइंग पेज नंबर 2. स्टूडेंट्स लेट्स स्टार्ट. टाइम एंड टेक्नोलॉजी आर टू इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर्स दैट चेंज सब्सटेंसेस इनटू रिसोर्सेज. व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स ऑन विच रिसोर्सेज कैन बी चेंज? इट्स टाइम एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. टेक्नोलॉजी मीन्स लेटेस्ट नॉलेज एंड स्किल इन डूइंग मेकिंग थिंग्स. एज यू नो दैट technology is changing day by day. As the time changing, technology, latest knowledge are being introduced. So time and knowledge are two important factors which change the resources. Both are related to the needs of the people. People themselves are most important resources. Which are the most important resources? We human beings. Because it's our ideas, knowledge, invention and discoveries. All these ideas, knowledge and invention, discoveries are done by the human being. That's why we are the importance for resources. Each discovery or invention leads to many other. The discovery of fire leads to practice of cooking. When we discovered fire, we started the practice of cooking. Resulted in the development of new modes of transportation. When the wheel was introduced, new modes of transportation was introduced or not? And the wheel was introduced by the human being. So as when there is a discovery of or invention of one product, the development of other modes also increases. Same way with the hydroelectricity has turned energy into fast flowing water into an important resources. See students, whether it's we talk about wheel, we talk about hydroelectricity, all this has been introduced, invented, discovered by the human beings. That's why people are considered as an important for resources. Our next topic is type of resources. Resources are being classified as natural, human-made and human. These are the three classification of resources, and further they are being classified in different sections. First is natural resources. Natural resources are drawn from nature and used without such modification are called natural resources. The resources which we get easily through nature is the natural resources, like the air we breathe, the water of our river and lakes. Soil, minerals are all natural resources. The main of these resources are free gift of nature. Question can be asked, what is the free gift of nature? Which resource is the free gift of nature? Is the natural resources and can be used directly. In some cases, tool and technology may be needed to use natural resources in its best possible way. Sometimes we can use natural resources directly and sometimes there are tools and technology. Machinery, technology, human beings, changes it and we use the natural resources. Natural resources are further classified into 4 parts, that is level of development, use, origin, stock and distribution. So let's start first with the development. On the basis of the development and use, resources can be classified into actual resources and potential resources. Students, all these terms can be asked for the short answer question. So please read it and understand it very carefully. What is actual resources? Actual resources are those resources whose quantity is known. When we know the quantity of the resource, which is known, is the actual resources. These resources are being used in the present. The rich deposit of coal of the Ruhr region in Germany and petroleum in West Asia. The dark soil of Deccan Plateau. We know that in Maharashtra there is a Deccan Plateau. Dark soil. So we know that. We know the quantity. That's why they're considered as actual resources. So what is actual resources? Are those resources whose quantity is known. And these are the examples. What is potential resources? Potential resources are those whose entire quantity may not be known. This is the difference also. In actual resources, quantity is known. In potential, and quantity is not known. They are not being used at present. They are not used at present. Actual resources are used as present, where potential are not used as present. These resources could be used in future. The level of technology we have at present may not be advanced enough to easily utilize these resources. The uranium found in Ladakh is an example of potential resources. So this uranium in Ladakh is the example of potential resources. Now we move on to the resources on the basis of origin. Natural resources on the basis of origin. Resources can be abiotic and biotic. Biotic resources are non-living thing, while biotic resources are living things. So this is the difference also. Abiotic resources are non-living thing and biotic resources are living thing. Soil, rock and minerals are abiotic, while plant and animals are biotic. Clear, students? Thank you.